What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 13 of the ultimate Let's Play Fire Emblem. Last time, we defeated Lord Lundgren, we completed Lynn's storyline, and now we're getting ready to start Eliwood's storyline. He will take over as the main character from here on out. We start with Chapter 11, Taking Leave. Now, before I get started here, I'm going to do something real quick. Make my suspend points here. And if you're wondering why I'm making two, this one's going to be, the first one's going to be for just my save games, and the second one I'm going to use basically turn by turn, just in case I screw up. So, if we get into a tough chapter and I start struggling a bit, I'll use these just to save time. So, just giving you a little heads up before we get started. I did mention I was going to be doing this. I wanted to get through Lynn's storyline without having to use these. I did, and now that restriction I've taken off myself, and we are going to go ahead and get started. This opening chapter for Eliwood's story is called Taking Leave. 1 year later. Once dragon fought man in a war called the Scouring. Mankind vanquished the dragons thanks to the efforts of 8 heroes. These 8 mighty generals brought peace to Elib. The continent was divided into nations, and the people enjoyed an easy prosperity. The hero Hartmut settled in the east and founded Bern, famed for its military might. St. Elamine moved west, and her sacred name flourished among the artisans of Etruria. The horseman Hanan's legacy lived on with the nomads of his beloved plains of Sakai. The birthplace of the knight Barragan is now home to the renowned knights of Ilia. The berserker Durban's final glory was to create a warrior's clan in the Western Isles. The archsage Athos is said to have retired to the barren wasteland of Nevada. The heirs of the champion Roland themselves became the lords of the Lycian League. Elib has enjoyed a peace that has spanned 980 years. How much longer can this peace stand before its foundations begin to crumble? Deep within the Lycian League lies Ferae, a land that has known no conflict for many generations, but which now finds itself touched by a shadow of unease. Its beloved and benevolent ruler, Lord Elbert, has mysteriously vanished, as have a number of his sworn men, loyal knights who serve at his side. A month has passed without word from the Marquess. Rumors of his death abound. However, the Marquess's son believes his father lives and has vowed to find him. Marquess Ferae's son, Eliwood, a red-haired youth who will one day become the finest knight in all of Lycia. His long journey begins here. Alright. It's almost like we're starting a whole brand new game here. Chapter 11, Taking Leave. Lord Eliwood, we leave on your word. I see. Thank you, Marcus. Mother, it's time for us to go. Eliwood promised me that you will return to me safely. I'm worried about your father, but if anything were to happen to you, my heart cannot bear that sorrow. I know, Mother. Please do not worry. Father is alive. I know it. I vow that I will find him and return him to your side. I have your word, then. Yes, of course. Isadora, I trust my mother to you in my absence. Yes, my lord. I will guard over her well. Mother, I will return. Rest easy. Well, Marcus, it looks like it's just the two of us. Not so, my lord. My man Loen will be traveling with us. Loen, that's reassuring. I've sent him ahead to the village. He hopes to seek out a few able men who are skilled in arms. Normally I wouldn't venture forth without a larger company, but I bow to your will in this matter, Lord Eliwood. I'm sorry, Marcus, but I would rather not deprive my mother of even a single guard. The best knights in the realm disappear with my father. If anything were to happen to my mother while I'm gone, I understand, my lord. What's keeping Loen? We've all heard that the Knights of Faerie have vanished, right? Well, your misfortune is my good luck. I have an announcement to make. As of now, this village is mine. Grozny is your new liege. Now bring every last piece of gold down to the smallest fleck. Lord Eliwood, Commander Marcus, I... Lowen, calm yourself. A knight must be in control at all times. The village is under attack. It's bandits. What? Bandits? Here? Are you sure, Lowen? This girl has more details. My Lord Eliwood, I'm the daughter of the village magistrate. My name's Rebecca. The bandits came without warning. They're stealing everything. I beg you, please help us. I see. Marcus, Lowen, we must aid the village. Yes, my lord. Rebecca, stay here and keep out of sight. If it please you, my lord, I would rather fight. I hunt almost every day and I have some skill with the bow. Is that so? Very well, but be careful. Yes, my lord. Lord Eliwood, one more thing. There is another in the village who has offered to help. A traveling tactician who was staying at the inn. A tactician? Yes, my lord. This is Mark. And we're back in the game here. Mark, do you know this person, my lord? Yes, I met Mark during the trouble in Kaelin last year. A fantastic military advisor memory serves. If not for Mark, the Marquess of Kaelin and his granddaughter, Lynn, might not survive Lundgren's uprising. What brings you to Faerie, my friend? Ha, still traveling about honing your skills? Of course, a worthy pursuit. Let's give thanks to Promise for our chance reunion. We have need of your aid. Please lend us your skill. Yeah, because we're going to need it, because they got a lot of numbers here. Alright, so we're starting off completely fresh here. Let's look at our units. We have Eliwood, has a rapier and a vulnerary at level 1. We then have Marcus, who's a paladin. He's already a promoted unit. He already has steel weapons, the steel sword and the steel lance. Steel weapons are more powerful than iron, but they're heavier, so you may not be able to get a double attack with them unless you're pretty quick or pretty skilled with them. But then again, Marcus is probably not going to get a lot of experience being that he's already promoted. So I'm probably going to be keeping his use to a minimum. Then I have Lowen, a level 2 cavalier, the same class as Kent and Sane were. He comes equipped with an iron sword and a javelin, so he's already prepared for multiple forms of combat. And then we have the level 1 archer, Rebecca. She has an iron bow and a vulnerary. So I'm only starting with these four units. We'll see how this first round goes. Now what happens if I go right out of the gate with Eliwood? Because I do want to get everyone a little bit of experience. Now I don't have a healer with me, so I gotta be careful. How about you? What can you do, Rebecca? Not quite enough to put him away. What about you, Lowen? Lowen will just flat out get the kill. Alright, so let's see what they're going to do here. Fortify their defense on that side. Oh, look who we got here. Look, Dorcas, can you believe it? It's just like that knight said, it's Lord Eliwood. So it seems. What's he doing? Hey, he's taking on those bandits. Protect the innocents? That's a right lordly thing to do, isn't it? Right, Dorcas? You talk too much. The lordly needs our help. Right. Leave these mountain weaklings to me. I'm Barter the Brave. So we just got two new allies, our old friend Dorcas, who I believe maintains his levels from our last adventures with him, and he actually has an energy ring. Magic or strength by 2, vanished after use, and he also brought another backup in Barter. He's a level 2 fighter, also with an axe, but he's only level 2, so maybe he'll want to get some experience. I think what we'll do is, now I want to do this. Because I would love to get, that item from him. Well, do I want to, Yeah, I'll save that for later. I'll just go ahead and have Barter attack this archer. At least he won't be able to counterattack. And then we'll have Rebecca finish this one off. Okay, Rebecca gets her first kill. You know what I'll do? I'll actually give that energy ring to Rebecca. He doesn't have a hand axe, so he's not going to be able to attack. Alright, so, in that case, let's pop you with the javelin. Actually got the hit there. Excellent. And maybe Eliwood can finish you off. I would have needed a critical hit there, and I didn't get it. You know what, maybe what I'll do is... I'll go ahead and take this guy out because he's already here. But I think Marcus is going to just protect us from the rear. Because, yeah, he only got 4 EXP points. Alright. I think I do see a armory over there as well. And, yeah, Eliwood got a little bit of healing from that fort that he's on. So, Barter can attack from a distance. And let's have Rebecca... I'll go ahead and just use the bow to attack. I'll hold on to the energy ring for now. Dorcas at the ready here. Right now, Dorcas is the only one in the line of fire, which is fine by me. Just in case, I'll use the vulnerary. And Marcus, if you could visit this village. Is Lord Elbert well? We've heard nothing but foul rumors hereabouts. Olive Foray is worried for his well-being. We hear tell that Lord Eliwood is going to find the Marquess. This dragon shield is our village treasure. It boosts the defenses of the one who uses it. Take it, please, and may it see you and Lord Elbert home safely. I think I'll go ahead and give that to Eliwood, just so he's got a little bit of defense, because he's still a little bit frail in terms of HP. He is hiding in that forest, though. Going to Dorcas. Nice work. So yeah, this is a relatively easy chapter, it seems, so just to get used to the new units. Rebecca, not quite a level up yet. Go ahead and attack with Lowen here. And we'll have Dorcas hit the shop here. They're only selling vulnerabilities. We start with 10,000 gold. I'll go ahead and buy a few. Whatever my inventory can handle. Alright. So I bought 4 vulneraries. I'll go ahead and equip, give one to Eliwood. And Barter, you might as well have one as well. We're actually going to try and trade it down the line here. So I don't know if I'm going to be using you yet or not, but we'll see. And in terms of the dragon shield, well... Who has the lowest defense out of all of us? Probably Rebecca would probably benefit the most. Dorcas I'm not going to worry about too much. Yeah, he's just out of range of Rebecca there. Okay, so I'll let Barter take this one. If he can, that is. He can. Alright. You go ahead and give, yeah, she has both the energy ring and the dragon shield, so. One of them now. Boost in strength. Let's see if we can lure some units in with low in here. I'll make sure he has the javelin equipped in case we go indirect here, which is, he was actually going for Eliwood there instead. He's going for Eliwood as well. You missed. Alright. Let Barter get the kill there. And you are going to go ahead and use your dragon shield. Lowen can take out this poor guy here. He'll get a double attack with the sword. And Lowen got just enough to level up here. Let's see what he gets. Only HP, not the best level up in the world. And what can I do with Eliwood? That's a little risky. I think I'm going to go ahead and just have him heal up one more time. And we'll get our other guys in range as well. And you know, you go ahead and pick up a few vulnerables as well. I'd rather have too many than not enough. Okay. And looking at my notes here, I think this is all we need to do. Alright, so let's see how well I can wear him down. We'll start off with Rebecca here. What is this, a pack of children coming to play? You think you can challenge me? What? Varian knights? But that's impossible. Believe it, buddy. Unfortunately, Rebecca missed. Barter, what can you do? You actually got him with 43% accuracy. Good job. Lowen, what can you do with the javelin? You missed. Dorcas needs to be direct combat, so let's see what happens here. Good, he missed. Good, and Eliwood should get the kill here. Not gonna worry about anybody else here. Give you one of these. Yeah, you're fine. Okay. Now he's probably gonna heal up a bit. After Eliwood is expected. Alright, Eliwood, take him out. Gotcha. I thought my luck was finally turning around. Alright, Eliwood gets his first level up. Let's hope it's a good one. Strength and defense, well, fine, but I'm going to need to get some HP later on. Now, can anyone seize the gate? No, it's got to be Eliwood, so I'm going to have to, Who needs, items? We're all covered. Alright, end it, and then we'll have Eliwood take the gate. You'd be Lord Eliwood, yes? Our deepest thanks for coming to the aid of our fair village. Think nothing of it, it's a lord's duty to protect the citizenry. Would that were true, my lord. The good folk of Laos know no such protection. Their Marquess Lord Darren is too busy preparing for war. He ignores all complaints of bandits and thieves. Preparing for war? Are you sure? I would not lie, my lord. My brother lived in Laos until a few days ago. His home was torched and he had no choice but to flee here. According to him, Laos could go to war any day now. It's all the people of Laos are talking about. Lord Eliwood, if this is true, the situation is a grave one. If Marcus Laos is raiding for war, his target is most likely another Lycian territory. Perhaps this connects to Lord Elbert's disappearance. My father and Marquess Laos? It seems a tenuous connection, but it's as good a start as any. Let us travel to Laos. We must learn more. Thank you for your guidance, Mark. Where are you bound for next? If you have no destination in mind, perhaps you could travel with us. Ours is a small group with a single purpose, to find my father. I don't know where our road will lead, but we will be strong with you and our company. You will travel with us? Splendid. Thank you. I pray we give you no cause to regret your decision. Rebecca, where do you think you're going, young lady? Father, I intend to accompany Lord Eliwood. Don't be ridiculous, girl. Lord Eliwood is not going on a picnic. He's riding into danger. I know that, Father. That's why I want to go. We owe him our lives, and I want to repay him. My bow may not be all that much, but I know it can be of service. And Father, I may meet up with my brother somewhere. You're the magistrate. You have responsibilities. This is all I can offer. I need to do this. Please, Father, let me go. Dear me, you're just as stubborn as your mother was. I'm sorry, Father. You must bow to Lord Eliwood's wishes on this matter. If he consents, you may go. Thank you, Father. Lord Elbert has always been kind to us. Follow his son with a true heart, Rebecca. Serve Lord Eliwood well as I have served his father. I will, Father. And we're off on a new mission with a new party, some new friends, and a couple of old ones as well. We'll head to Laos in the next episode, but for now we're going to go ahead and call it quits. Thanks for watching. Until next time, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.